Hi, and welcome back to Level 3 of Lesson 6. What we have here is the cash flow that we generated in Level 2, just copied and pasted into a new sheet. I'm going to rename this sheet to High for the High Capital option. As you recall from earlier, the zone is going to go with the 8% loan from Fido's bank in order to buy the $1 million worth of equipment needed to launch TZ Edge. I've added the loan details up here. We also have the depreciation values here and the tax rate here. A new piece of information we have here is the hurdle rate. We'll get to that in a minute though. Now that we have the cash flow projections completed for this funding option, we can now analyze the numbers a few different ways using some new uber cool formulas. These are a few standard ways of analyzing financial information. The first way that we'll look at this scenario is to look at the net present value, or NPV. What this means is that we're going to look at these future cash flow numbers and discount them back to today. In other words, are these amounts more or less than what we could get if we took that $1 million and invested it into some other financial venture for 5 years? Will that option generate more of a profit than us launching TZ Edge with $1 million initial investment, knowing that the projected cash flow numbers for TZ Edge are estimated to look something like this? So basically, what is this present value a year from now, discounted back to today? What's the second year's value discounted back to today? This third year's value discounted back to today, etc. We remember that there is a present value formula, PV, that would tell us how much the present values of all these numbers would be in today's dollars, and we could then add them all up, but there's a better way, and that's the net present value, or NPV, function. Let's say that you have this 5-year cash flow projection here for TZ Edge, and another group in the company has determined that they can take the $1 million and invest it into a venture that will make the company a 25% rate of return over the 5 years. This 25% becomes your hurdle rate. So the question for your team is, can your project clear that 25% hurdle? You need to see if your investment is better than theirs for the overall good of the company. The NPV function takes the yearly cash flow numbers as well as the hurdle rate, and it will generate a number that's either greater than zero, equal to zero, or less than zero. If it's greater than zero, then we know that TZ Edge will make more money than if we invested the $1 million in some other investment at that given hurdle rate. If it's equal to zero, then the two different investments are equal, and if it's less than zero, then the other investment would be a better choice as it would make more money than we would by launching TZ Edge with our $1 million investment. To better visualize this, let's create a little hurdle rate table down here so that we can analyze our NPV against a variety of different hurdle rates. Let's start out by putting a 20% hurdle rate here, and then a 21% here, and then we'll copy that value down. We now have some hurdle rates below and above 25% just to see how the NPVs will compare for the different hurdle rates. Let's use our NPV formula here to see if we get positive, zero, or negative values. Equals NPV, the hurdle rate, and then the values here in years 1 through 5. One thing we can't forget though is that we made an initial investment of $1 million. In order to take that into account, we need to add that value here to the end. Since our initial investment is actually an expenditure, it's a negative value, so that correctly gets subtracted from our overall analysis. Hitting enter, we see that we get a positive value of about $1.06 million. This means that our TZ Edge investment will make this much more than a competing investment in some other venture that has a 20% rate of return. Let's make these parameters mixed references so that we can drag that formula down, and then drag it down, and we see that TZ Edge still outperforms all of these hurdle rates, so TZ Edge appears to be a pretty awesome investment. I'm now curious though, at what hurdle rate would our TZ Edge investment fall below zero? Let me show you a couple of alternatives. Using our existing NPV function, we can just insert a bunch of rows here, and copy the cells down, and copy the hurdle rates down, and then copy the formula down, And we see here that in the 46% hurdle rate, we fall into a negative value, so that means the rate of return for the TZEdge investment is somewhere around here between the 45 and 46% hurdle rates. But what exactly is our rate of return? Guess what? Oh my lord, yes, there actually is a formula that calculates the rate of return for our investment. And it is called the IRR formula, internal rate of return. This formula will determine the hurdle rate for which our investment returns a net present value of zero. For the IRR function, we just have to give it the values, including our initial expenditure from year zero to the end of year five. There is a second optional argument that's called the guess. The way that this function works is that it will guess at an initial value of 10% and then guess again to see if it generates an NPV of zero or just comes closer, and then keeps guessing about 20 times, and it will try to get the NPV exactly to zero in those 20 guesses. If you know about where it's going to end up, you can give Excel a hint, and that might increase the accuracy, but for most small data sets like this, you can get by without it, so I'm going to leave that guess out completely. So now with an IRR of 45.6%, that means that if the zone took that $1 million and had a different project that it could invest in, that project would have to have a rate of return greater than 45.6 in order to have a positive NPV. So the net present value and the IRR, or internal rate of return, are two pretty good indicators of whether or not this project is a good investment for the zone. If nothing else, if the zone has a variety of ideas, commonly called a portfolio, on how to spend $1 million, it will give you a pretty good idea of how to rank them in order of projected cash flow. Some other indicators for analyzing this projected income are the return on investment, or ROI, and the payback year. How long will it take to pay back the $1 million and actually start generating a profit? Let's first talk about the return on investment, or ROI. This is simply the sum of all of the projected profits divided by your initial investment. This turns out to be negative since our initial investment was a negative number here in this cell. So if we put a negative sign in front of this formula, it gives us an accurate picture. This tells us that the ROI is actually 419% over 5 years. This is a big number and would cause most companies to jump at this opportunity. What about the year when we consider the initial investment to be paid back? If we look at the income after taxes up here, we took out $1 million, and in the first year we lost even more money. The next year we start to earn a profit and make a good chunk of our $1 million back. If we go into the third year, we see that we pass the $1 million plus this loss here plus quite a bit. This means that at some point during the third year is the break-even point, and we're able to pay back our $1 million in full. So now we have several pretty good indicators that this project will do well and better than the other choice that we've measured our predicted success against. We know that the net present value is positive, the internal rate of return is significant, the 5-year rate of return is awesome, and the 3-year payback is pretty quick, even though, like most projects, it starts off pretty slowly. That's it for now. See you in the next video.